My name's Richard Goodall from Terre Haute, Indiana. I've lived in Terre Haute my whole life. I was that kid up in my bedroom with the Radio Shack stereo. My favorite thing was just to sit up and listen to my music, and I'd just belt it out. Eventually, I was like, I gotta find me a job. So I became a janitor at Chauncey Rose Middle School, which is only 3 blocks away from my house.
My first job in LA was sweeping floors, and I used to sing to myself. That's the thing.
That's how I keep up my voice. Is this?
I'm not a fancy person. I take out the trash, I wipe off the tables, I sweep the floors. I'm just having fun, and I'm trying to make people happy. The kids would hear me sing, and they tell me, I've got talent. That's why I'm here. That's why I got on a plane. When I took off from Indianapolis, I felt that front wheel come off the ground, and you have this floating, you're no longer stable. And that's what this whole experience is like right now. I mean, it's a good off balance, but until you actually do something, you don't know if it's right for you or not. Oh, I'm getting chicken skin talking about it.
It's time to meet the judges. Thank you, sir. I'm with you.
Hello. Very nice to meet you. And what is your name, please?
I'm Richard Goodall. I'm from Terre Haute, Indiana.
Richard, how old are you?
I'm 55.
55. And what do you do for a living?
I've been a janitor for 23 years. The kids call me Mr. Richard.
Okay. So tell me what the big dream is, please.
My big dream? I like to sing. I love to sing. So.
Okay. Does everyone know you've come out today to audition?
Just my close-knit friends and my fiancée, Angie.
Oh. Is she here with you today?
No.
So she's the one you're going to call after the audition, yeah?
Yes, immediately, yes.
Okay. All right. And the song you've chosen today, tell me why you chose it.
The song speaks for itself, so.
Okay. All right. I'm not going to ask any more questions. Let's do it. Good luck.
Ooh.
Ah, you're a bit nervous.
Yeah.
It's okay, Richard.
This has been a long time coming. So.
Oh, bless you.
Let's go, Richard!
Shake off those nerves. We're here. We're rooting for you, Richard. Good luck. I hope he's good.
I know. I
really do.
Just a small town girl.
Oh my God.
Living in a lonely world.
What?
She took the midnight train going anywhere.
No way.
Just a city boy. Born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going. Share the night, it goes on and on and on and on.
in the door. Nothing is different. Richard, you are my hero. Facing these halls, trying to talk. Because that was special. Genuinely special. I think America is going to love you.
I mean, that was spectacular. That was fun. This was an amazing surprise. I think you were perfect to come to AGT because you made our night.
Thank you, man. You're beautiful.
You, and maybe because you've been doing it for 23 years, but you just cleaned up. You know, I would imagine every kid that has ever been in a school with you is just screaming. I just think you're amazing.
We love you, Richard!
Richard, 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 you knocked me off my feet. I mean, we all had the best time with you up there on that stage. I really, really feel something when I see you up there and hear you up there. And now, this is what I'm gonna do for you, because I love you.
I'm late, but I'm here right now. Though I used to be romantic, I forgot somehow. Time can make you blind, but I see you now. As we're laying in the darkness, did I wait too long to turn the lights back on?
What? I feel better.
That was amazing. I can't wait to see what you're gonna sing next.
Here, stuck on a hill, outsiders inside the home that we built. The cold settles in. It's been a long week.
He deserves it.
And now I think we should go and call your fiance. Should we call her?
Go and call her.
Oh my gosh, you guys. I've never even been on a plane. This was not on my radar to come to California. It's just a dream come true.
Happy you came.
I got the gold buzzer. She said, I knew it, I told you.
That was amazing. That was incredible.
And this is for you, little keepsake.
Thank you so much.
From your golden buzzer.
Thank you so much.
I always just love singing. It makes me feel happy. Even when I was like 4 years old, I would just pretend like I have a microphone and I would just like sing like I'm singing to like the whole world. My grandma always tells me sing my heart out and that I would be one day in that big stage. But I'll be really nervous of Simon because like if somebody does a little mistake, he can like.
I want to see the Heidi, I want to see Sophia, I want to see how they dress up.
What are you doing in my interview? My little sister always interrupts me, but she loves me.
I want you to get the GB.
What's GB?
Don't you know it's golden buzzer?
Oh, golden buzzer. I'll try, it's kind of hard.
It is.
I feel like literally I'm dreaming because my big dream is like singing in front of, I don't know, like so many people. And I'm in that big stage. Oh my God.
Do good.
Okay. Now it's coming true. I can't believe it. I can't believe it. It's happening.
All right, have a great time. Come on out there, family.
Bye. Welcome to America's Got Talent.
Thank you.
You have the perfect look for the audition today. I love the look, love the dress. Who are you and where are you from?
Angel. My name is Pranayska Mishra, and I'm 9 years old, and I'm from Tampa, Florida.
From Tampa, Florida. Welcome. How does it feel to be 9 years old on the biggest stage in the world?
Scared and, of course, like, really excited.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Who did you bring with you from Florida?
I came with my mom, my dad, and my little sister.
And who is going to be the first person that you're going to call if this goes well for you today?
Definitely, I will call my grandma because she always wanted me to be in this big stage, and now, finally, I'm here.
Oh, my gosh.
Can I ask one question? Who's your favorite artist in the world?
I have more than one.
Go on, give me a couple.
Aretha Franklin, Whitney Houston, and Tina Turner.
Okay.
And who would be your favorite judge if we're talking about favorites?
I have more than one.
No, you can only say one.
I don't know. It's you and Heidi.
Oh. It's me. It's me.
It was going so well.
Is everyone in here ready to
yep.
hear? All right. The stage is yours.
Here we go.
She's funny.
When I was a little girl, I had a rag doll, the only doll I ever owned.
That's big boy.
Oh my gosh.
Now I love you just the way I love that rag doll, but only now my love has grown. And it gets stronger everywhere. And it gets deeper.
Simon or Sophia has to say.
What?
Really?
I want you to call your grandmother and say that Heidi Klum pushed a golden buzzer for you.
Pranayska! How do you feel right now?
I don't know. I just feel so... I don't know.
Are you shaking?
I just have been
like,
doing
I'm
this
shaking
about.
Too.
Congratulations. You deserve it. You are absolutely incredible.
Why is my reflection
someone else?
Oh, come on back here, guys.
Hi, Grandma. She did really, really well, Grandma. She got my golden buzzer.
What? Oh, she's crying.
I'm so excited for you, and I can't wait to hear what you're going to sing next.
I mean, she actually is
really
good.
Hello.
Hey.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Very well. And what is your name, please?
Reed Wilson.
Very nice to meet you, Reed.
Nice to meet you, too.
And where are you from?
I'm from Alabama.
Oh, fantastic.
All right.
Okay. And how old are you, Reed?
I'm 14 years
14.
Old.
14. Okay, I'm guessing you're going to sing?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so how long have you been singing for?
I've been singing all my life, but the past year I've been kind of working on it a lot more and singing in front of people more and just pursuing it because it's definitely my dream.
All right, Reed, we are all rooting for you, and I always say this, and it's happened, 2 minutes really, really can change your life.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So let's see what we can do.
All right.
He is so nervous.
Can you imagine what this is like?
Come on, Reed.
One of your many toys. You don't own me. Don't say I can't go like other boys. And don't tell me what to do. Don't tell me what to say. And please, when I go out with you, don't put me on display. 'Cause you don't own me. Don't try to change me anyway. You don't own me.
Take that mic, man.
Don't tie me down, 'cause I'll never
say.
Reed, we weren't expecting that. Hi.
I think you're absolutely incredible.
Thank you so much.
I love how you also took your mic off and then you just gave a little bit more stage presence. Well done.
Sophia.
You were so nervous at the beginning. I'm like, oh my God, he's not going to be able to put his stuff together. But you did, and you did amazingly. It sounded spectacular from here.
You know, I shut my eyes for a moment when you were singing, just to listen to your voice, and then I open them again, and there's this sweet young kid. Is there one artist that's inspired you, Reed?
Yes. I love Aretha Franklin so much. Oh. And that's definitely the dream, to have like a big name like that.
She was the best, wasn't she?
Yes.
Your parents must have great taste in music, right?
No.
Yeah. He sold you out. He sold you out.
I was bowled over because I was surprised. I got surprised, first of all, you're just a 14-year-old kid from Alabama, so I would imagine, I put myself in your position, you were very nervous, and you did come off incredibly nervous. That was a surprise.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You know what? That stage is where dreams come true.
Yes.
Do you believe in dreams?
I do, yes.
Well, one of them is about to come true.
Buddy, you are amazing. He is amazing. So surprising. Yeah.
How do you feel, Reed?
I'm a little starstruck, honestly. Just, thank you so much. Thank you, all of you guys.
But especially
one more time for Reed.
I love it when he said his parents were like,
I know, it was like one. Yeah. He must be tortured all the time when they put music.
Yeah.
Why did I do it?
Yes, yes.
I did it because everything, the sound and who you are, is nothing close to anything I was expecting. You're a big talent. Aretha is in the room. Yeah. You're the best.
Thank you so much.
See ya, buddy.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Very well. And what's your name, please?
My name is Liv Warfield.
Liv Warfield.
Yes.
And tell me a little bit about you.
Oh, well, I am from Chicago, Illinois, by way of Peoria, Illinois. I sing a little soul, rock and roll, R&B, everything.
And you write your own material?
I do write my own music, yes.
Yeah. And yes. This is something you do full time?
Absolutely. Oh, yes.
You've done what? A lot of gigs?
Yes. I've been on stage with the greatest in the world, Prince. And also Nancy Wilson of Heart. I've been on a lot of stages, and I'm just glad to be here to be able to do the music and do what I love. I just want to represent that, you know?
Amazing.
Thank you.
So I ask every singer this, Liv, how are you finding the music business in general as a performer?
I've been doing this for a long time. And the industry is really hard because things have changed over time.
Yeah.
But I continue to push just because I feel like I have a story. I have it. I just want to inspire people because I haven't quit.
Right.
And I won't.
Right.
You know?
Well, the great thing about having an audience is we feed off the audience.
Yes.
You know, that's why we have an audience, you
yes,
know?
Yes.
So when we feel that energy, it makes our job so much easier. So forget about us.
Yeah.
They're
yes.
the only ones that matter.
100%. Yes.
Okay. Should we do it?
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
All right.
Okay.
What's up? How you doing?
Wow, that's a big band.
Wow. Oh my God, how many?
Yep. In 3, 2, go.
Well, if you stare at it long enough,
wasn't long enough. Seriously, that lyric, Wrecking Ball, that summed up how I felt just then.
Okay.
It was like being, in a good way, punched in the face by your energy, the band,
yes.
All these years of frustration,
yes.
And you've come on here, and I'm sorry, I can't give you a yes. I've got to give you one of these.
So what if it hurts me? So what if I break down? So what if this world just throws me off the edge? Feet run out of ground. I gotta find my pace.
Thank you. Come on.
Thank you.
That was unbelievable.
I'm overwhelmed. so grateful. We all do it because we love it so much. We live through the music. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Give it up one more time for Liv Warfield.
Great things are going to happen after this. You deserve that.
Thank you.
Yeah.
That
is the very least I could do.
Bless.
Really?
No, really. We are all thankful. I'm thankful.
Oh, my God. You've just made our show great. Thank you.
Blessings. Thank you.
Come on. Oh, that's for you.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, my God. That was amazing.
Thank you.
wave, wave.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, darling.
Hello, everyone. My name's Sydney Christmas.
Is it?
Sydney Christmas.
That's an unbelievable name. I love that.
It's terrible, isn't it?
It's not.
My middle name's worse.
What is it?
Mary.
No. Sydney Mary Christmas.
Did your mum
seriously name you that?
No, I'm joking. Yes. I ain't really.
Okay. Oh my gosh, that is genius. Sydney, where are you from?
Raised in Kent, just moved to London.
Are you a student? Do you work? What do you do?
I'm currently working front of house at a gym.
Oh, brilliant.
Ooh, yes.
Fantastic, but that's not what you want to do.
No, absolutely not.
What do you...
No.
What do you want to do, Sydney?
I'm trying to be in the West End. I just want to sing.
Oh, bless her.
What are you going to sing for us today?
The first song that I ever sung, actually. I haven't sung it in 24 years.
How old are you? You look 24.
28.
20 great.
Good answer.
Thank you.
There you go.
So what song did you sing it for?
Tomorrow.
From Annie?
From Annie, yeah. Oh.
Simon, that is Simon's worst song.
Hopefully I'll sing it better than when I was four as well. Well.
So do we.
I can't wait.
Thank you.
Come on, Sydney.
Come on, Sydney.
Let's have it.
The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow till there's none. I'm stuck. The day is gray and lonely. I just stick out my chin and grin and say, oh, the sun will come out tomorrow. So you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may. Come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow. You're always a day. way up high.
Sydney, look at that! Look at that!
To make an audience want more. Tease them, bring them in, make them believe, hit them with this huge note. It's just art, it's art, art.
You are full of character, personality, you've got it all going on.
I think for me, what struck me so much about you is just like how naturally funny, how warm, how brilliant your presence was the minute you walked on the stage, but how you were like entertaining everyone, but then you brought us the most heartfelt, beautiful version of that song. And that was the best version I have ever heard in my life. So I'm gonna do this.
We just heard in the room, it was, you know, it's rare.
Thank you so much. Thanks for screaming for me.
Everyone's aware, you know, it's tough to get that break, you know, for something which you really love. You so deserve what you just got.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Your control was amazing. And I used to hate that song, and now I absolutely love it. Good for you, that was brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
See you in the live show!
What just happened there?
She really deserved that little show.
So good, yeah. She proper gave me chills all over my body. I was like, oh my God.
Everybody was just in the palm of your hand.
I have never experienced anything.
Oh. Really?
Ever. I really felt hurt. That was something.
Oh, good.
I will never forget that.
I look at her and I go, my daughter's gonna love her, my nan's gonna love her, and my mum's gonna love her. Yeah. That's how I always judge it, like the three different generations. Yeah.
What's your name?
Taryn.
Taryn, where are you from?
Egham in Surrey.
I used to live there. Englefield yes. Green.
Englefield Green is where I live. Yes.
OMG. Taryn, why have you decided to come on Britain's Got Talent?
I love to make people smile, and I think my voice is all right. So.
And Taryn, did you bring anyone with you?
Yeah, I did. I brought one of my students, Lexi Ray. She's Woo! Over there. Aww. And she's with her mum. So I work with special needs children to use music as a way.
If you won Britain's Got Talent, how would that change your life?
It would mean everything.
Well, darling, listen, you've got 2 minutes. Take a deep breath. Good luck.
Thank you.
tones and raspiness that, you know the old saying, you could sing the phone book. I feel like you've got that classic voice. But above and beyond that, you, my darling, you are special.
Honestly, from the minute you stepped foot, just chatting to you, you are so down to earth, so sweet, so humble. And then you knocked it out of the park. But I can see how much that moment meant to you. You're physically shaking now, and I'm thrilled, absolutely thrilled you've got this chance.
Thank you so much!
Because I know I'm not bragging here, but I had the honour to meet Carole King. She stayed at my house. And when you started this song, I said, God, how is she going to do this? You made me forget about her version. You made it so much your own, with so much feeling, and the colour of your voice is unique, and you're a very, very, very special person, my darling.
Thank you so much.
You sold us a complete dummy, didn't you? I mean, yeah, I'm all right. Yeah, I might do okay.
I could see you were nervous.
And I was thinking, this probably isn't going to be very good. and then you started singing. And this is how people should sing. This is proper, proper singing. Has someone ever told you that you couldn't do this?
Yes.
Okay.
I could see you were nervous, and I was thinking, yeah, I bet you somebody at some point has said to you, you haven't got a great voice or nothing's going to ever happen, and boy, did you prove that person wrong. And that's what that golden buzzer is all about.
Yeah.
And Bruno, brilliant.
Yes.
And you are a little star.
Thank you so much. Get the gold!
Superb. Absolutely superb.
That was great.
You're the best!
How did it feel?
I don't even know what to say. I think I've wet myself.
Gosh, you've brought a lot of people with you. Tell me your names, please.
So I'm Ravi, and this is my sister Ma, and this is my mum and dad.
Very, very nice to meet you. And how old are you?
So I'm 8 years old.
Okay. What made you decide to do this?
I've watched BDT all my life and always wanted to audition for it. And 2 years ago, I was diagnosed with a brain tumour, and I'm here to show no matter what life throws at you, you can still achieve your dreams.
Good for you. And how are you right now?
So, my brain tumour is stable, but I'm still living with the day-to-day effects.
So you've had a really tough time, haven't you?
Yeah.
Tell me about all these people behind you.
So, to support me, I brought a group of my friends and teachers from school, my family, some medical professionals who have helped me during my diagnosis, some other amazing children from the brain tumour community.
Oh, God. Mum and Dad are joining in.
And what are you going to be doing for us today?
So today we're doing a choir performance of A Million Dreams.
Oh, my God.
OK. Take your time. Whenever you're ready, we're ready.
Call my own.
daughter. We are someone's son. How long can we look at each other?
Talented, very brave, very special person. I'm so happy that you've had this moment, because you deserve it, all of you, by the way. That's what I call magic. And that's why we have the golden buzzer for people like you. You so deserve it.
You know, the golden buzzer is such a personal thing, and I always say I can only press it when it feels right, and you're such a remarkable young man.
You're a hero.
You really are.
The moment you started talking, you just had me.
Yeah.
What did you say? And, I just loved it. Oh, so God. Well done to all of you.
Thank you for doing it.
Yeah.
We'll see you in the live semi-finals. Congratulations!
Welcome!
Hello!
Hello, who are you?
I am Rebecca Strong.
Rebecca, where are you from?
I'm from Prince Albert, Saskatchewan. I'm Dene Suslene, so I'm First Nation.
And what do you do?
I sing.
How did you get into music?
My dad was a musician, and he started a band with me and my sisters when I was younger, and I continued.
Does this mean a lot to your family as well, then?
Yes, of course. They're actually in the crowd right now.
Are you nervous?
I'm nervous. There was a saying, if you're not nervous, then you're not passionate about it, so.
Well, the stage is yours. Good luck.
Thank you.
Happy for you, no.
be stone cold stone.
Well, I wish I could make this, but here's my goodbye.
What are you thinking?
I'm just very, very happy that I could touch so many people's hearts tonight. This stage has brought me a lot of confidence and just showing who I am.
You know what? You have such a beauty. You really do. And a sweetness. And I think you're not only making Canada proud, but you make your Indigenous culture very proud. That was an amazing moment, young lady.
Well, thank you so much.
The prize for Canada's Got Talent is $1 million this season. Every golden buzzer is $25,000. How would that change your life?
Money doesn't buy happiness, of course, but it would change our life. My parents, my dad especially, he's old, so I would love for him to retire.
Daddy, stand up! You know, I am a believer that every person on this planet has a purpose. You're here on this stage, proving to yourself you're a singer, showing exactly who you are. Right now, this moment, this is your purpose. And you know what my purpose is?
Sharpest words wanna cut me down.
My purpose is to help people like you.
This is brave, this is bruised, this is who I'm meant to be. This is me.
Straight through to the next round, and you've just won $25,000 from CIBC! Woo! Rebecca, how do you feel?
I feel amazing right now, like on top.
Dad, how do you feel?
I'm so proud of her. She's worked so hard, and she's an angel.
She is an angel, Rebecca. You are our angel. One more time for Rebecca Strong!
Thank you, guys. Woo!
Hello, hello, welcome.
Hello.
What's your name?
My name is Jade Mathieu.
How old are you?
I just turned 15 years old.
15? Wow, incredible, very young. What are you going to be doing for us today?
Today I'm going to be singing for you.
How do you feel? Are you nervous?
Kind of nervous, but I'm not. I'm more nervous about the talking than the singing part.
You're more nervous about this part right here?
Uh-huh.
Really? Why is that?
Well, I've been diagnosed with autism a few years ago, and talking always been hard for me. That's why I'm singing. I can just express myself.
Absolutely. Who is here with you today?
Well, I got my mom off stage right here.
Hey! Let me ask you this. You're on the biggest stage in Canada. Why CGT?
I want to win.
That's what's up. Well, I love that. Best of luck to you. The stage is yours.
Thank you.
Look at me. You may think you see who I really am, but you never know me. Every day is as if I play a part. Now I see if I wear a mask, I can fool the world, but I cannot fool my heart.
To a 15-year-old. That was incredible.
You are a perfect example of what a million-dollar winner could look like on this season of CGT.
Absolutely. This is Canada's Got Talent, and sweetheart, you showed this theater, you showed the judges, and more importantly, yourself, that you've got talent. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
I think that this stage in this country is about diversity, and that includes neurodiversity. And that spectrum allows you to shine in different ways than another person. You are a beautiful young lady with an amazing talent. You really are. And what do you want in life? What are you looking for?
I want to be a singer and just travel the world with my singing.
You want that? You want that dream?
Yes, definitely.
How can that come true for you?
Canada's Got Talent.
With Canada's Got Talent.
Yes.
So you want to be on again, right?
Yes.
You want to go farther than you've already gone.
Definitely.
I can help. I can help you. I can give you this. Kiddo, you're amazing. You're amazing. You're amazing. You're amazing. What are you thinking? Isn't she amazing? You are a star. What I watched, what I heard is worth $1 million. It really is. Thank you.
Jade Mattia, you are Howie's golden buzzer, which means you're going straight through to the next round. And you've also just won $25,000 from CIBC. One more time for Jade Mattia.